The broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
Hello everyone, good morning and good afternoon for some of you. I'm glad to be here with you today again for this new series of webinars after the small break during the summer. I hope that you are doing well and we enjoy to be with you today. So this first webinar of September is dedicated to a case study that we built successfully with one of our best customers, the Adecco Group, which is a Swiss company. So we'll see a bit more details in a few minutes. For your information, as usual, you will be receiving an email with links to the video recording as well as the slides after this webinar, if you want to share it with some colleagues or partners, or if you want to review and replay it. So you'll be receiving that automatically after this webinar. You get a panel on your right side, which is a GoToWebinar control panel, where you can raise your hands if you face any technical difficulty with voice and video, just in case you don't hear me well or you don't see my screen. If you want to communicate with me, you have to use the questions pane within this control panel. That's the only way to communicate with me. Please don't hesitate to ask your questions during the presentation and demo, and I'll be glad to answer as far as I can the questions at the end of this webinar. So this webinar will be for the next 30 minutes, and we will start now because I don't see any technical issues nor questions. So that means that you should see my screen and hear me properly, I hope. So thanks a lot, and let's start. So today we are going to look into the details of the Adecco app case study, which we started as a pilot project and which finally became year after year an indispensable internal sales tool. So let me go to the next slide. The Adecco Group in a few KPIs. For those of you who don't know, this group is one of the worldwide leader in human resources solutions, which is playing in about 5 continents and 60 countries and territories. This is one of the top 500 accounts from Forbes selection. And in France, the Adecco Group employs 9,000 employees. They shape the future employment landscape and they leverage a lot of the digital ecosystem and latest technologies to help your enterprises with the transformation required in terms of skill sets and job staffing. They have about 9 brands, if you don't know them precisely, 9 brands dedicated to all sorts of staffing and HR requirements. So they provide temporary staffing, permanent placement, recruitment process outsourcing, managed services, talent management, and much more. Sorry for the diagram, which is still in French. I couldn't find one which is as good as this one, because in a snapshot you can see that this is a group where the turnover is 23.7 billion euros. They have about 34,000 employees, permanent employees, spreaded in 5,100 agencies and offices. They serve about 100,000 enterprises per day, and they have about 700,000 employees, job profiles in their database per day. So this is really a big staffing group. So what is the what is now the I'm sorry, I'm trying to get access to my PowerPoint. Yeah, so I think my PowerPoint is going to crash maybe. Yep. So let me come back to my second slide. First slide. Okay. Sorry for that interruption. So what was the initial goal of the Adecco group? So we met with them end of 2015. It was in December. You will see the history and the agenda we did with them, the slide after. We met with them, so in December 2015, and we had a, let's say, a requirement scope to build a sales enablement app for their mobile task force, their sales staff in the field, to provide them with the latest version of their presentations. The main goal was really to help the sales staff to prepare and get access to all the materials, presentation materials in their hands, with a mobile app, both on iOS and Android devices. So that was the initial goal. We had about 1 month, less than 1 month. It was about 3 weeks, in fact, to build this app with them, which our tools can help you with, because our solutions and tools are dedicated to no-code mobile app developments. So you don't need to be a developer or technical computer science guy to be able to build an app with our tools. And this is what they really liked in our story, because that was really possible to build that app, and we did it in less than 3 weeks. Their main requirements were about the capability to store and disseminate all their presentation materials in one place, but also make sure that their consumers, who would be the sales staff, would be able to access very easily all the documents with a proper categorization of the documents in themes and subthemes. Also, the ability to access and present these documents wherever they are, whatever internet access they get, which is sometimes difficult to get, you know, even in some good places like big cities. It's still often difficult sometimes to get a proper data and internet access. So the goal of that solution is to provide them with a tool where they can download up front before they leave the office or their home, before they reach the customer site. They have a capability to download the materials they need and then be able to play with them and play them in front of the customer without internet access. Also, they wanted an expert in the transformation of digital documents, because they had a lot of legacy documents. So they really needed some help on how to build the new mobile digital documents. As you probably know, you cannot present a PowerPoint file on a mobile device the same way you would present it on a video beamer or on a desktop or laptop machine. So you need to really design and build your materials dedicated for the mobile channel. And this is where we were able to help them with these layout design recommendations, but also graphic staff forces, because we did the first initial step with them. They also wanted an expert in app submission process, because they wanted to make sure that it would be ready in less than a month. So not only we had to build the app, provide the contents, but also we had to submit the app to the Apple App Store and Google Play Store, all of that in less than 1 month. And they wanted naturally the app to be scalable, so that solution to be scalable, because at the beginning we had only one business unit within the app. And they wanted to make sure that along the way, we would be able to integrate the other business units. They have about seven business units at Adecco Group, and we already have now five business units using the same app, which was part of the requirements and scope, as you can see. So what were the tasks we had to perform in less than 3 weeks? We had, first of all, to define with them the app architecture. When we say app architecture, that doesn't mean anything regarding or relating to the code or the way to develop the app, because as I told you initially, our tools are aimed at people who know nothing about the mobile app development languages and tools. So the app architecture is mainly about how do you want to architect your document, visual materials, where do you want to place them, because we have a system of banners and what we call store models, which has a new name now, which we call Stitch. That's the name of a product. And with these banners and store models, which are really the show storefront of your app, you can by yourself define the order, the sequence of these banners and the categories you want to place your content in. So all of that things, you can do it yourself, but they wanted us to build it up front for them because they have no time to do it initially in 3 weeks. Then they wanted us also to help them create the first documents, the first visual materials for the app. So we did it because we have a very skilled graphic design force at Rakuten Aquafada. So we are usually able to help our customers to build the initial content and materials. Or if we don't, we have partners in every country who can really help you to do that. So we had to transform about 15 legacy documents, which were heavy PowerPoint files that they had before, into mobile-ready documents ready for the app. So that's what we did during these 3 weeks as well, to transform them. So we had PowerPoint files, we had PDF files, and they are now building InDesign rich, engaging documents with our plugin. And last but not the least, we had to submit the app to the store, which we were able to do all in these 3 weeks. So what was the history of a relationship which is very good and still continuing to evolve? As we told you, it was very fast at the beginning, and this is probably one of the key factors of our solution and services, because we are able to help you to build your own mobile solution, whatever it is, because we provide not only sales enablement app solutions, but we also provide HR solutions like onboarding apps, e-learning apps. We also provide marketing and communication apps. We also provide press publishing apps. What is the main commonality among all of these domains is that we have expertise. And we can help you to build the initial phase, the very first step of your apps with our tools. And then, thanks to a knowledge transfer, you will be able to manage it yourself. But if you want, you can start from scratch with our tools without any help from us or from our partner. But we really recommend that you get some help at the beginning to fasten your process. So that's exactly what we did for Adecco Group, because we met, as you can see, mid-December 2015 with the head of digital marketing and communication department. We had the order by mid-January, so in less than a month, and we initiated a project at that time, and we had to submit and publish the app by mid-February 2016, which we did on Apple and Google App Stores. That was an app again for iOS and Android smartphones at the beginning, and 15 documents to start with. Then in March, we performed a training on site and also a full knowledge transfer, so that they are fully capable of managing the app and the contents by themselves since that time. In May, we also integrated their users directory through our SIML connection, which was initiated just at that moment. And by December 2016, they added about 37 additional rich documents to the app. So this is also a very important factor, because when you build and deploy an app, you need to make sure that it will be used for a long time, and not only download it and then they try, and if they are not, if the users are not happy with it, they will move it to the trash, as you know. In order to keep the pace of your apps and also engage your consumers of the app, you need to make sure that you provide regularly new content, new documents, or at least documents updates, because with this platform you can update your documents and your consumers or readers will be notified of a new version of these documents. Also, in January 2017, they wanted finally to extend the scope of the app to tablets, not only smartphones as designed initially, but also tablets. And that's why they redesigned the storefront of the app, which we call the store model. They redesigned it to fit as well with tablets. And you will see in my live demo that we have both apps for smartphones and tablets since that time. They also wanted to create new dedicated content for mobile users. Again, as you know, you don't create the same kind of content when you're consuming after the content on a mobile device compared to a desktop device. So we help them to create these new contents with our plugin to Adobe InDesign, which they use intensively. In 2017, also, they extended the scope and the reach of this app to four additional business units, which makes a total of five now. Using this app regularly and intensively. So this is really now a fundamental tool within their sales staff across these five business units. And in November 2017, they also launched a new version of the app with a new design, again, because they had more and more documents, more and more business units. So they had to revise and review the app structure, the navigation scheme as well, because too many categories, too many documents in one place could be also disturbing the user. So we help them to really synthesize the categories and facilitate the navigation with very few banners, as you will see in the live demo. And in by this year, they extended again the number of documents, which reached recently 88 documents, and that's still moving up, and they want to launch the web version of this app by the end of this year using our web kiosk version of our famous next-gen template app. So as you can see, this is an ongoing live project with this customer, and they take it very seriously because the users use it intensively in the field, and this is again becoming a very fundamental tool for their sales staff in the field. So now let's have a look at this solution. So this solution, as I told you, was built for smartphones and tablets now and soon for the web as well. So this is a short video before we jump to the live demo. This video, you can find it again in our YouTube channel if you want to see it, or on our website in our case studies. You can see some screenshots of the app. This one is important because this is the authentication screen, which we will skip in my demo because I already authenticated. So before we go back to the solution itself, let me show you now the app itself. And before that, let me check that you have no question or issue, technical issue. Apparently not. So that means that you can follow me properly. Thank you for that. So let's have a look now at the app itself. So I will be using my iPhone, but it's, as you understood, it's available as well for Android devices, and not only smartphones, but for tablet devices as well. So I'm gonna go to the app itself, which is available on the App Store, both from Apple and Google side. The screen that you don't see, but that you would get if you launch the app very first time, would be a login screen, because they use the force login option when they built this app with our tools. The force login enforces the users to identify with a password before it gets access to all this content. So this is usually used when you publish an app on a store, on a public store, and you want to make sure that only your internal users will be using it. Remember that you can also decide to publish and disseminate your app within your enterprise mobile force with whatever solution and tools you would be already using in your company, like MDM tools, for instance, mobile devices management tools. So you're not obliged to publish an app like this on public stores. It's only if you want to make it easy for the download and install of this app wherever your employees or users are in the world. So once you got authenticated, you get access to this app. This app is divided into three parts. If you don't know our next-gen template, because we provide you with our tools, what we call a next-gen template, where you will be getting at least a few root features that you can then personalize. So you get the top bar where you see, and sorry, this is in French in my case, I didn't install it as English version. But the home button at the top means that you are on the home page. You could get, in addition to this button, you could get as well a search button, because we also provide a full text search capability now with our apps, which we don't use yet. You could get as well what we call a burger menu, like on a website on the top left corner, which would bring you immediately to a specific category of your content. But in that case, we prefer to make it very simple, so that the user is not distracted by many buttons and he sees in the main storefront, which is a central part of this app, he is discovering now all the business units' home pages. So you get Spring, which is one business unit. You get Adecco, which is another business unit, because you get Adecco France, for instance, Adecco USA. You get another business unit there, the medical business unit, the pontoon business unit, and others, which are the five business units already in place. And at the bottom part of this app, you would find fixed buttons that you can personalize the first time you build the app with our tools. So you get a home button, which gets you back to this home page anytime you're in another tab. You get the Adecco Group button, which is usually the website of your company. So in that case, the Adecco website, the French version. And you get also the profile button where, as you can see, I'm logged in as the main project manager of this project at Adecco Group. And we thank Patricia again for her help in that presentation, because we were allowed to show you some parts of the app, because we'll keep the main stuff confidential for sure. But you could log out and log in as another user within the same app. If you don't want to use the forced login option, you have also another option, which is making your app more open and public, I would say, with some public content and documents inside. But then you could hide and lock some documents, very confidential documents, for some specific users using our voucher mechanism, which you can discover in one of our previous webinars on our YouTube channel if you want to see how tools are working. So let's now get down to one of these business units, like this one. The button means I discover, because this is French, and then you get two main buttons each time in each business unit. The first one means I want to prepare myself for the next customer meeting coming up, so I'm preparing myself. Or I want to present something for my customer meeting, which is probably going on at the moment. So this way, that's exactly what they wanted to provide to their sales staff, a way to prepare the meeting before they get to the meeting itself, but also be able to present anything on their mobile device at the meeting place when needed. This is approximately the same behavior for all sales enablement solutions we sold on the market. PwC, PricewaterhouseCoopers, is using the same solution with different content and materials for their sales partners in France successfully, and using the same kind of approach, which is getting the sales partners a way to prepare their meetings before they get to the meeting place, and also all the presentation, the latest presentation materials in the app. So when you click on I present, then you get access to all the categories that you could be able to present to your customer. Remember that we are speaking of sales staff from Adecco Group, so people who are selling the services, so all the staffing services and HR services from Adecco Group to their companies' customers. So if we look at the Adecco Group, for instance, which is more a public kind of presentation of the group, you would see different categories still in French because this is mainly used in France as of today. And you would find different categories, like, for instance, the first one is about recruitment, placement, and temporary staffing. If you click on the first button, which is a website icon, you would get to the proper place on the Adecco website. The second one would bring you to a legacy PDF, which is available to present the Adecco recruitment and placement division. And then you can get this way many places. If you want also to share this content that you just showed to your customer with your customer, you have a share button, which would then immediately send the URL or could be a deep link, as we say, to that document within the app to your customer. So let me come back to this place. So you would find the same behavior for most of the other business units. If you click on prepare, then you get access to the same kind of categories, including a toolbox, as they say, where you can find different rules, engagement. You can see very nice content like this one, where you can schedule your content, you can prepare, you can schedule your meetings, sorry, prepare your meetings, get access to the knowledge base, etc., etc. So these are access, direct access to the internal systems of Adecco, but easy to find within the app. Then you would have other documents, like understanding how the customer journey works. However, we can come back to the main store now. And this is the main behavior that we would find if we go to another business unit now. I could go to this one, for instance, click on I discover, click on again, I present, and then get, as you can see, a different way to show the categories of content, because the first business unit, which was the main Adecco business unit, is grouping all the categories. In that case, we are in a sub business unit, so we have specific, let's say, content in these categories and so on. So in that case, I need a log. So I won't use that. This is a direct link to box. So this is what I wanted to show you. If now you want to have a look at what it would look like on a tablet, I have it also on my simulator, just to show you that it's exactly the same behavior, but with different visual, because you need a bigger visual when you are on a tablet than on a smartphone. But globally, the behavior is exactly the same. You can click, for instance, on this Discover button, you can click on I present and get access to the same documents. So again, this is what you would get. Just to summarize before I answer any of your questions, this is what we provide as part of Sales Enablement App. Remember that a Sales Enablement App is very efficient for your sales staff in the field, because mostly today the main tool that we all use everywhere is a smartphone. So providing them with the latest up-to-date information, an easy way to find and access their content, but also provide them with engaging content and not classic PDF or PowerPoint presentations. Get them access also to online and mobile training, because we provide quizzes and e-learning features. Making sure that the content is secured and that only specific users are accessing the content at a specific time is also very crucial for this kind of apps. And finally, measuring the app and users' behavior, making sure that you create and provide with useful and valuable content to your users. So you need to measure, and for that purpose, we provide and integrate the main analytics tools on the market. So Again, this is information you can find back on our website, on aquafadas.com website. So I won't get into these details now because I think you got the main points. You can find us again on aquafadas.com. If you are interested into knowing more about Adecco Group, you get also their URL now. And let me come back now to your questions. So let me go back to the questions pane now and see if you have any questions. So one question is about analysis tools. Do we provide any graphical analysis tools? So this is a very good question because we had one before, which we finally got rid of because it was not enough accurate. We are redeveloping and reintegrating a new analytic tool for a reporting tool so that you get a nice reporting dashboard within our web front end. This is on the way, and for that purpose, we are working tightly with other Rakuten business units because we are part of the Rakuten ecosystem now. And so we are integrating the Rakuten analytics, which is far beyond from what we had before. So let's stay tuned and in sync with us, and we'll let you know if you follow us when it will be available. So do you have any other question? I don't see any other one. We reached the end of the webinar. It's time, but if you have any additional question, I can stay online for you. If not, I want to thank you again for attending this webinar. And again, you will be receiving a link to the video recording as well as my slides, probably tomorrow or the day after, but very soon. Thank you again for attending. Have a very good day, and see you next time for our next webinar.